In this video, we're going to look at the anterior and the posterior tibial arteries, as well as the arterial blood supply of the foot and ankle. And to do that, we first need to look at the posterior aspect of the knee, because as the femoral artery comes down, it becomes the popliteal artery in the popliteal fossa, where it branches out supplying the knee with blood. Then in front of the popliteus muscle, it will end up by dividing into two terminal branches, and these are the anterior and the posterior tibial arteries, and those are the arteries we're going to focus on in this video. So let's repeat some bone anatomy first by looking at the scheme a little bit. Here you see the tibia and the fibula, the medial and the lateral malleolus, then the talus and the calcaneus. And between the tibia and the fibula, there's going to be the interosseous membrane. So now we got the popliteal artery coming down and giving off the anterior tibial artery while continuing as the posterior tibial artery. So both the anterior and the posterior tibial arteries are a terminal branch of the popliteal artery. The posterior tibial artery descends between the deep flexors and the soleus muscle and then curves posteriorly to the medial malleolus, where it now goes to the plantar surface of the foot and divides into two terminal branches, the medial plantar artery and the lateral plantar artery, as you see here. Now, the tibialis posterior supplies mainly the posterior compartment of the leg, the muscles of the posterior compartment of the leg, and it does that by giving off some side branches. The first one is the circumflex fibular artery. You're probably already familiar with this one if you know the patellar network, because this one will wind around the fibular head, as you see here, and it will go anteriorly to supply the knee with blood. Then there's the fibular artery, or sometimes also referred to as the peroneal artery. It starts from the upper third part of the posterior tibial, and then it descends along the posterior medial aspect of the fibula, and end up at the calcaneus as a terminal branch, called the calcaneal artery. Another side branch is the medial malleolar artery for the medial malleolar network on the ankle, and the lateral malleolar artery from the tibial artery for the lateral malleolar network. Then there's the calcaneal branch to form the arterial network over the calcaneus. So the posterior tibial artery give off the calcaneal branch, and the tibial artery terminates as the calcaneal artery. Then the last branches are the nutrient branches for the bone marrow. Both the fibular artery and the posterior tibial artery have these branches. So that was all for the posterior tibial artery. Let's do the anterior tibial. Again, the popliteal artery comes down and divides. The anterior tibial artery will sneak out between the tibia and the fibula and wind anteriorly, where it ends at the first metatarsal space, as you see here, where it now becomes the dorsal pedis artery. Now let's do the side branches. Now the anterior tibial will mainly supply the anterior muscles of the leg, but the first side branch is the posterior tibial recurrent, which branches out right before the anterior tibial artery reaches the anterior surface, as you see here. And we also have the anterior tibial recurrent artery, which branches out when the anterior tibial artery reaches the anterior surface. These two will go up and supply the knee with blood. Then we have the anterior lateral malleolar and the anterior medial malleolar artery for the blood supply around the ankle. And that was mainly all the side branches of the anterior tibial artery. Now, let's do the dorsal pedis artery. And to do that, I think it's better if we change up the scheme a little bit. Now, the dorsal pedis artery, as you know, is a terminal branch of the anterior tibial artery. There are only three side branches of the dorsal pedis artery. The first side branch is the lateral tarsal artery, which starts at the level of the caput tuli and goes laterally to supply the structures there. Then, since we have a lateral tarsal artery, we will also have a medial tarsal artery, which supplies structures on the medial side of the foot and muscles of the first toe on the plantar surface. So it winds around going to the plantar surface. Then there's the arcuate artery, which passes laterally, as you see here, and anastomoses with the lateral tarsal artery. So those three are the side branches of the dorsal pedis artery. Now, as the dorsal pedis artery continues, it ends up by splitting into two terminal branches. One is called the first dorsal metatarsal artery, and the other one is called the deep plantar artery, which pierces the muscles of the first toe and ends up in the plantar surface. Now, for the arterial supply of the toes, the arcuate artery will give off the dorsal metatarsal arteries, which give off perforating arteries, and then continue dividing into the dorsal digital arteries. Three dorsal digital arteries for the first dorsal metatarsal, and two for each of the other dorsal metatarsal arteries. So that was all for the dorsal pedis artery. Now let's do the posterior tibial artery, which, remember, divides into two plantar arteries, the medial and the lateral plantar artery. At the base of the fifth metatarsal bone, the lateral plantar artery turns medially and anastomose with the deep plantar artery of the dorsal pedis, as you see here, and they form an important arch on the plantar surface called the deep plantar arch. So let's look a little bit into that. On the plantar surface, we have the lateral plantar artery, and on the dorsal surface, we have the dorsal pedis artery. They connect through the deep plantar artery, and they form the deep plantar arch. So the deep plantar arch starts from the fifth metatarsal to the first interosseous space. The perforating arteries from the dorsal metatarsal will connect with the deep plantar surface to get a nice collateral blood flow. And then again, just like the dorsal surface, the deep plantar arch will give off five plantar metatarsal arteries, which will divide into proper digital arteries. But for the medial plantar artery, however, the artery anastomoses with the first dorsal metatarsal artery and supplies the muscles of the first toe, as well as supplying the rest of the first toe with blood. So that was everything I had for the posterior and the anterior tibial arteries, and I hope this was helpful.